In the Quran, angels do not get hungry, thirsty, tired, or bored. They don't have gender, but they have two, three, or four wings. All angels praise and glorify God, and they never become tired of doing this. Angels are drawn up in ranks. They fear their Lord and do what is ordered. And they pray that believers be brought out of darkness into the light. God sends the archangel Gabriel to the Virgin Mary in the form of a man. Likewise, angels also visit Abraham and the prophet Lot in human form to warn them of the imminent doom of the people of Lot. There are Hafaza, the guardian angels, and the Kiraman Katibin, the noble recorders, who write down people's good and bad deeds. There are angels who violently pull out of the souls of the wicked and who gently draw out the souls of the blessed. There are those who carry the throne of God, those who drive the clouds, and those who distribute provisions and blessing. In the Quran, angels would also help the believers during the battles. They always help believers who sincerely struggle in the way of God, regardless of time and place. Among the other angels specifically mentioned by name in the Quran are Gabriel, the Archangel Gabriel, who is responsible for revealing the Quran to the Prophet Muhammad and also communicating with all other prophets before. Michael, who is responsible for carrying out the natural events such as wind, rain, thunder, snow, and Malik, who is the guardian of hell. Music.